Have you ever wondered what it would take to get a cup to fly in the air? Yeah, me too. Welcome to Impossible Science. Hey everyone, it's Jason Latimer, the world champion of magic, coming to you with another Impossible Science. Now, today's topic is levitation. And while you may have seen magicians levitate cups before, much like the opening of this episode, that's an illusion. But today, I'm going to show you that with a few modifications, we can take two cups and use its shape to make them fly like a paper airplane. Seriously. So grab a couple cups, some tape, and about three or four rubber bands, and I'll meet you at a table surface. Okay, for this levitation, we're gonna use air pressure. Now, you've heard me use air pressure before when we used it to break boards and we've used it to make objects hover in the air. But today, I'm gonna show you how to manipulate it to create what's called the Magnus effect. No, not magnets, Magnus effect. But before we get into it, let me show you a little experiment. This is a magic soda can. No, just kidding. It's just a regular can, okay? It's empty. But right now, when I set it on the table, gravity's holding it down, but we have equal air pressure on this side, and even inside, because it's open. It's equal on all sides, which is why it's sitting still. But I'm gonna blow air on one side of this can. What that's gonna do is faster moving air will create low air pressure. Now, what that means is there'll be low air pressure on one side and high air pressure on the other side. So guess what happens? The can will be pushed into that low air pressure pocket. So if I blow on it on this side, you're gonna see the can move that way. Did you see that? I'll show you again in slow motion. It's actually moving towards the low air pressure pocket. Let me magnify the effect with a second can. If I blow down the center of these two cans, the low air pressure pocket on this side will, and the high air pressure over here will push this can this way. Just as much as there'll be low air pressure pocket here and there'll be higher pressure pocket here. So if I blow air here, this one will move this way. So instead of being pushed apart, they're gonna connect. Perfect. They connect, not magic, science. Now, imagine if there was faster moving air on this side and slower moving air on this side. Well, that means there'll be low air pressure here and higher pressure here. Now imagine it being turned sideways. If I can get faster moving air on top and higher pressure on the bottom, we can create lift. So how are we gonna do that? We're gonna take advantage of the shape. See, we're gonna get this spinning in the air like this. Now what that's gonna do is if this object is moving through the air and it's spinning this way, well, this rotation is helping the air over the top. It's assisting it move faster, just as much as it's slowing the air on the bottom. You'd have low air pressure on top, you'd have higher pressure on the bottom. That creates lift, and that gives us the Magnus effect. So let's turn that into an airplane, seriously. All you need for this one are two cups. Oh, okay, and just kidding. You need two cups, we're gonna need four rubber bands, and we're gonna need some tape. Now, it's very easy to make. You just place the cups base together, and we're gonna place some tape all the way around it. This is what I'm doing. I'm just placing the tape right down the center. And we don't want it to be loose. We want it to be pretty secure because it's going to be spinning. We don't want it to fall apart. Now we're going to take these rubber bands and we're going to interlock them with each other. And we're going to create one long elastic like rope. Now I'm using four rubber bands, but you could use five. Probably need more than three. Three would probably be the low end. And now what we're going to do is we're going to take this stretchy rope and we're gonna wrap it around this. Now, the way I'm gonna wrap it is so that you spin it around, just around the base like this, nice and tight, and stretch it out like this. Now, what's gonna happen, when I pull this back and shoot it like a slingshot, what's really happening is it's gonna uncoil through that rubber band, which gets it spinning. But it's also shooting forward because we just shot it like a slingshot. You're gonna have the cups rotating like this, creating low air pressure on the top, high air pressure on the bottom, and we create lift. That's right, these cups are gonna act like a paper airplane. The faster you get it spinning, the more lift you'll create. Like that. You should probably do this outside. I'll take this outside. All right, let's give it a shot. Pretty cool, right? I hope you enjoyed this episode of Impossible Science. If you did, let me know by smashing that like button and subscribing to the channel. And until next time, stay curious, because the right question changes everything.
That's about 20 feet, by the way. They go a lot farther than you think they would.